After hours of searching, I have found the wild animal himself. All the way from New Zealand, Mega Eminence is at the desk with your boy, Dr. Curry, and what a series I've managed to pull for us. Yeah. Mega, is it Mega? No, it's not Mega, sorry. I just realized that. It's like, wait a minute, he's playing. So, no, it's actually the Fraction, who are absolutely crushing it, against Avant. Like, these are some absolutely massive names in the Ozco community. Eminence, you're now, come at me, chat. I'm willing to say Eminence is one of the best players in the scene right now. Oh, my phone's going off as abuse already. How do you feel about these two teams?
Well, obviously, we just played the Fraction not that long ago.
Did you beat them?
Yeah, we won 3-1, but God, were they such close games.
Really?
Yeah, really intense. We only won, like, the hard point by 1 point.
Yeah?
I almost choked it. I couldn't even get into the hard point right at the end. And then S&D, 6-2. Uplink, wow. They absolutely smashed us.
Really?
CTF, yeah.
So is your uplink weak, or were they just, like, some next-level stuff?
Our uplink's, like, really 50-50, I feel.
Okay.
So, like, comeback, I'm comfortable with our comeback. But Detroit, no. Okay, and that's the map that we had to play.
Detroit. Right. Yeah. Well, it's getting told right here. Last time I checked, you only dropped one map. Have you since then lost any more maps?
No. Well, that was like our last game that we've played.
I love it. I like how you're just so chill about it. It's like, nah, haven't lost a map.
Only one.
Easy. This is my boy Eminence. We met AVT 2013, didn't we?
Yeah.
Dude, we have had a bromance of all bromances. Like, you guys...
I'm so happy to be casting with you as well.
We made it. We have, like, planned this for, like, 2 years.
It's crazy.
Like, it's just... Oh. It's a bromance. I'm not even ashamed. Let's go into the gameplay. Let's get straight into this. It will be... Do you want to control?
No, you can...
No? Control. Okay. All right. Let's have fun here. But you know what? We're on board with Luca, the young king himself. Used to be... on one of the best teams in Australia, Curse Australia, then that broke up. Half of the players moved over to XL5 in future months. That's a little brief update of him. The whole TF team, to be fair, is pretty godlike. And they have Killer Pie. Now, you teamed with Killer Pie. Have you?
Yeah.
Yes, you have. Okay. How do you feel he's settling into this team?
Well, I don't know what to expect from Ryan, which is Killer Pie. You know, teaming with him for 6 months, I think, during Ghost. You know, he was a good player. He's always been in the best team in NZ, which was IG. And I thought that he'd fit in with TF well.
You know, you just had, like, the best opportunity to be like, yeah, he was on the second best team. Mega, you know? You should have just self-plugged yourself.
Well, I can't say that. I mean, IG did beat us at the last AVT.
True. Okay. Back to reality we go. Oh, Killer. Did he use this when you teamed with him?
No. Oh, thank God. We didn't have any LMGs in Ghost, but he used it against us.
That's a lie. There were LMGs in Ghost. Remember the thermal one on Freight?
Yeah, but we didn't use it. We didn't use it.
Okay, so you weren't the scumbags.
Nah.
Apparently, Killer Pie has developed a nice little habit of pulling out an LMG. Anyway, look at the scoreboard. That's an early break for TF. Now, these guys basically have been preparing for an event since Advanced Warfare came out. This is the first LAN event from the ANZ scene, besides AVT, or for Australian residents, that has actually been all ages. And, like, all of the guys from Avant were at the APAC Finals. Even Killer Pie was. I love these events because it just shows the diversity in the age groups and the skill gap. You know, you got people like Blue, Swifty, and Luke who are just shredding faces of some of the guys that we saw at the APAC Final.
Yeah, like every single player in this game right now, they've always played at a top level. You know, like Avant are just a well-known name. But, you know, an interesting thing is, when you think about it, all these teams sort of came together at around about the same time. So, you know, like, TF picked up Killer Pie to fill in at the same time, like, after APAC. Everyone made team changes after that.
Yeah.
So, everyone's pretty even right now at this event, and it's like, as you can tell right now, it's like 50-51. All the games here have been pretty close, and it's just amazing to watch. It's been such a great event.
It's absolutely nuts here. But let's we'll get into a little bit of play-by-play for you guys. How does that sound right now? We are on board, of course, was Blue. He's actually 12 for 9, so he's got the most kills for the team of TF. He's also equal for the most next to Hopi right now, trying to get the rotations down to the lower side of the map. How important is rotations on a map like Retreat?
Oh, I just saw someone fell off the map.
Yeah, no, don't mention that. That didn't happen, guys.
Spawns on this map, it's definitely something even we struggle at. Spawns are so important on this map. You know, the Turtle Hill and the top Apartments Hill, mm-hmm. It's really big. And, you know, what TF are doing right now is so good because they're already holding that side, so they're going to have the spawn to the next hill. And those are two hills that you can get a lot of time from.
Well said there by the... Do you classify yourself as a pro? You don't
no,
have to answer it.
Or no, I wouldn't say a pro just yet.
Top level amateur.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I was honestly just curious because you're sponsored by one of the biggest, esports sponsors that are out there. Mega, absolutely huge. You don't need my congratulations. Done it time and time again, though. I just, you know, normal question. TF actually have a bit of a lead here. What do you now? Okay, I'm just going to go into a little bit of a dribble here. From the series that we've been watching throughout the day, it seems as though the final 20 seconds in the hill, like, I know there's 40 getting subtracted from there, but the final 20 to me are the most important because it seems as though teams disregard that 20, but they do it time and time again on constant hills that, you know, a fairly substantial lead gets built off it. Does your team, or do you feel as though guys don't put a big enough focus on the scrap time, like the final 20 seconds of a hill?
Yeah, I actually disagree with that. I think
really?
The beginning of the hill is the most important.
Okay.
You know, if like you can get all your teammates in there and sit up and just absolutely like slay everyone, you can be like set up for a good 30, 40 points, which means that you'll win the majority of the hill.
So, is the scrap time important? Like, in terms of you being Omega, do you feel as though it's an important thing to focus on?
Well,
or?
Of course it's important, but I don't think that it's worth like putting so much effort into it.
Okay.
I think spawns are more important than
So you'd rather
else.
Get the rotation, get the proper spawns, and the chance of the 40 than getting the 20?
Yeah.
Okay. That's interesting. It's kind of like the whole, would you rather go for the dunk for the 2 points or the throw for the 1 point?
Yeah, yeah.
Which we will see later on. We'll discuss that as there will be potentially an uplink. Oh, we might have an uplink. It all depends. I'll have a look at the map rotations for you guys. But Hopi, he just got Avant the points to take the lead. We haven't seen them in the lead for a while now. So they've actually pulled it back. TF, they were leading. Now all of a sudden, it's gone back in favor of Avant. But it's in the open hill. It's in the first hill. Eminence, do you put a big focus on time in the original hill?
Yeah, the first hill on this map is actually a really interesting hill. I feel like right now it's actually quite 50-50. And Avant are just... Well, actually, Switchy just got a two-piece there, which pretty much locked in the hill. But Avant have the spawn to the next hill right now, so that's going to put them in a better position for the Turtle Hill unless Swifty can slay out here, which it looks like they're going to do. All of TF are pushing for around the back, and Swifty there getting a kill. But Avant pushing in through the jump over wall. And taking out Mac have taken out Blue, so now Avant have control. There's two members from TF pushing into this Turtle Hill, and yeah, it's just so close, man. It's crazy
ridiculous.
How close it is.
Yeah, we've been seeing games constantly on the live stream, just close maps. Even if the series score ends up being something like a 3-0, or you know maybe more 5-0, they're close games.
Yeah.
A lot of them are close games. Maybe the Search and Destroys can be a little bit one-sided at times, but it's just been some insane gameplay that's been going on right now. And TF and Avant are just living up to the hype right now. Final 15 seconds in this Turtle Hill. Blue is going to get the final few seconds. Now, you do notice the rotation's coming in from Avant, so they've done obviously what you were discussing of they want the spawns more than the scrap seconds. That has given TF roughly a 10-point lead. So Avant, they're going to aim for that 40 like you talked about.
Yeah, well, Benno, he just got taken down there. That was actually a pretty big kill. And see, like, that's the thing you don't want to happen, though. If you're going to rotate first and sit up, you've got to make sure that you can hold it. Because then you can get, like, that good time. Mm-hmm. Which, obviously, Avant weren't able to do now. Now TF have control. And there's only one member of Avant left alive. And now Avant have to get control of this hill, which they're struggling right now. All of them are scoring down pool, and TF are just slaying them out.
Yeah, I was actually trying to switch through the Avant place, you know, see them on a defensive structure, and they just got broken. Every single one of them died from the pushes from the Fraction, and they're doing extremely well right now. Hill is contested. They have a nice little lead. Now Maka trying to lock it down. He's got tagged up. Plays everywhere. It's a little unfortunate. Three of them just storm into the hill. Luka doing quite well. 31 kills for Swifty. Do you expect him to be performing as well as he is?
Swifty, yeah. Yeah, I mean, like, I think always Swifty's always been, like, a great player. You saw it. The last LAN, which I think was ACL Sydney a while ago, where...
that was July last
team,
year.
Yeah, him and his team actually won. So, like, he's definitely proven himself on LAN. I think winning that would have given him confidence in future events. But right now, this is, like, the biggest lead I think we've seen. Right? Like, TF are up by almost 50 points. God. And so I think it's safe to say that Avant really needs to step up their game if they want to win this. I don't think it's definitely still possible.
Yeah, it's we're not saying right now that TF have got this one in the bag, because how many times have Avant had the lead? You know, it's just been going back and forth between the two, and I think this is roughly the second or third time that TF have a substantial lead. But you never know. There's a minute left. There's still plenty of time. If Avant can lock down and maybe get this final scrap 10 seconds, just, you know, pull it back a little bit. You never know. I'm going to be interested to see how much of focus they put onto it. It looks like they do want to get the final few seconds. They want to get the scrap time. But into the last hill we go real soon. I think my maths, don't quote me on this, I think it's mathematically impossible.
I think it is. Right now, what I'm looking for is Swifty to get this 40 bomb, maybe even a 50 bomb in the last 1 minute that they had. At the moment, like, TF are just... They know that they've won. They're just playing for KD. They want to look good on the stat sheet.
Is that something you do?
If we won, then sometimes,
you want that KD to look good, don't you?
I know that yesterday we were playing and I was getting, like, extremely hungry. So after I knew that we won, I just put down the controller and started eating some KFC. But, you know, a lot of players do like to play for that game KD.
I tell you what, Swifty, like, it's... He just broke 40.
Yeah, this is the 40 then.
It's not like he needs to try, because he's just getting so many kills. Like, they just almost come naturally to him. He's winning a solid amount of his gunfights, or at least trading them out. You know, he's got 36 deaths to him. But that's going to be game. That's going to be the Fraction. They're going to take map one of this series, put it next to their name, Avant. They actually just came off a brutal game in the loser's bracket that went all the way to six maps, where they ended up winning, I think it was 5-1. Don't quote me. I will check that up for you guys. But that's going to be first map done. Would you say that's a convincing win?
No. That was extremely close.
It was. Like, what about in the end?
What's the end score? Like, it's they won by 30 points. You know, that's like half a hill. That, in my opinion, that's still close.
That's still close. Okay, so you think 30 seconds. There it is, right there. The Fraction, they're going to actually take map one. Guys, make sure you stay tuned. We're going to have a Search and Destroy up next. Before we do it, who's the strongest Search and Destroy team? Avant or the Fraction?
I'm going to say Avant. I know that, you know, like KillerPy said that he was pretty much teaching TF how to play S&D.
Oh, really?
So it'll be interesting to see what they do now.
Okay.
But I've played with Avant as well. I've played with Hopi. I've played with Maka and stuff like that. And they're a very strong S&D team, I feel.
Okay. Well, what are your guys' predictions? Tweet them at myself, at Reef or Eminence over here. The Twitter handle is just down below. We want to know who you think is going to do it. So we're going to check that during the break, which is going to happen right now. Guys, we're going to have some, just got moody here at the Does Play Land. Stay tuned, plenty of action coming up.